assistant professor, so I enter shows all the time. So I'm usually on the opposite side of the fence. And it was a real pleasure to get to go through all these works and sort of help curate and make a show. When I arrived today and I walked into the space, and I haven't seen any of these works, you know, ever in person, just small little slides on the computer. It was so nice to walk into a show that everything just spoke to me, and I liked everything. I don't think I've ever been to a show where I sort of hand chose everything, so I was delighted with the way that it turned out. So when doing a show like this and going through all these entries and trying to sort of figure out what would make a good show and then also what would make a good work, I'm usually looking at, and when teaching as well, I'm looking at things that are both aesthetically pleasing, well-made, showing nice craftsmanship, originality, but I'm also looking for things that also have content that show me some side of humanity, some side of the struggles that we go through or the joys that we see, just something a little bit more than just being a beautiful painting or a beautiful sculpture, and I think that all of these works do that, so I hope that everyone enjoys the show.
Thank you, Allison. I'd like to announce who our winners are. You can pick up the gallery guides and see that for yourselves. Winners, if you are here, we're going to get you a certificate and walk to the lab so you can get you your money. But I'd like everybody to meet the artists. So, our first place Best in Show winner, quite sure she's not here, is Alexandra Sulby, and she is from Pennsylvania, with her piece Sunshine, Lollipop, and Rainbow Come for a Visit. So she's the winner of the $650 Best in Show Award. Our second place winner is Provincial Hound, Leslie Shields. She is a Cincinnati artist, so I'm not sure that Leslie is here. Our third place, Remnants of Ella, $250 award goes to Greg Sand.
He's too modest.